Good morning, students. In this session, let us discuss the same lesson, construction, exercise 6.2. This exercise 6.2 is related to construction of tangents. Here we are going to construct a tangent from the given point. Before going to the first question, let us recall what is tangent and how many tangents can be drawn from the given point. As you all know, the definition of tangent. Tangent is a line segment which touches the circle at one point. So, if any line which touches the circle at one point, we call it as tangent. And here the three points, as I told you, it may be inside the circle or on the circle or outside the circle. If it is inside the circle, we can't draw any tangents to that circle. So, no tangent. If the point is inside the circle, we can't draw any tangent. If it is on the circle, if the point is on the circle, we can draw only one tangent. One tangent, and that tangent is perpendicular to the radius. And we proved this by theorem 1. Next, the same point is outside the circle, we can draw two tangents to a circle, and these two tangents are equal in length by theorem 2. Let us move on to first question. What is the question here? Draw a circle of radius 6 cm. First, we have to draw a circle of 6 cm radius. From a point 10 cm away from its center, construct the pair of tangent to a circle and measure their lengths. So first, let us write the data. What is the data? Radius is equal to 6 cm and point is equal to 10 cm. So here, let us take 6 cm radius. 6 cm radius. So let us draw a circle, 6 cm radius circle. Radius circle. So let us take this point as center O, and radius 6 cm. This radius is 6 cm. Radius is 6 cm. So now here, first step is draw a circle of radius 6 cm. We did the circle of radius 6 cm. Now, from a point 10 cm away from its center, that means from the center we have to take 10 cm on point. So let us take a point from center O. Already the 6 cm itself radius, the remaining is 4 cm, so 10 cm. So this is point P, so overall length from the center it is 10 cm. Here you have to observe here, from a point 10 cm away from its center, or it is away from the circle. Sometime instead of center, they'll give circle. From a point 10 cm away from its center, or from a point 10 cm away from its circle. When they give away from its center, radius will be included. Radius is included in this case. But if it is 10 cm away from the circle, at that time radius is excluded. Will not consider the radius. From the circle itself, we'll draw 10 cm. But here the radius is included. From the center means from center to point B, it is 10 cm. In that, radius is included. The remaining 4 we will draw. Otherwise, if it is from the circle, the radius is excluded. Radius is separate. From the circle, you have to take 10 cm again. So next step, drawing perpendicular bisector for this line OP. Perpendicular, how to draw the perpendicular bisector? Taking more than half. From point B, cut an arc. From point B, cut an arc. So we got one. Draw a perpendicular bisector. drawing perpendicular. Here we got one point, name it as M. Take it as M, midpoint. So now, taking M as center, OM as radius. Observe here, taking M as center and OM as radius. Taking M as center, this is, let M be the center. Measure this radius. This is not 6 or 10. It will be different here. Observe here, OM. So from OM, draw one circle. Take radius, correct measurement. So now, keeping at M as center, OM as radius, draw circle. So we got one more circle. And here, two circles are meeting at two points. Here one point, here another point. Name it as A and B. Okay, look here. First, the given measurement of circle. Then from 10 cm away from the, means from center you draw, take 10 cm. Here radius is included. Remaining 4 you will take. Overall it became 10 cm. And name it as P. It is an outside point. Now OP. For this OP, draw perpendicular bisector. And that intersecting point, take it as M, midpoint. And keeping M as midpoint, measure OM and draw a circle for both, which touches the given circle. So now let us join PA and PB. PA and PB, join PA and PB. PA and PB here. PA and PB are required tangents. P and PB are required tangents. So we constructed a tangent. Now the thing is, here we have to measure their lengths. We have to measure their lengths here. Let us measure their length. So from A to B, it is from A to B, it is 7.7. So PA equals 7.7 centimeter, and remaining PB is also 7.7 centimeter. PB is also 7.7 centimeter. These two are the measurement of this tangent. Again, I am repeating, first draw a circle of given radius and take a measurement what they have given from the center to that point, and draw a perpendicular bisector for that point. Then taking that intersecting point as M and radius from the center, OM as the radius, and draw another circle. These two circles meet at two points. Take one as A, another point as A. If we consider P as an external point to the circle, so we can draw two tangents. So P and PB are required tangent. If we measure them each, we got 7.7 centimeter. I hope you understood. Watch once or twice. It is better. You can, along with this video, just you practice in notes.